So make sure you find that comfortable position that's suitable for you. So whether the legs are out long, or you can allow the knees to bend with the feet touching the outer edge of your mat and your knees collapsing inwards, or take it into bound angel, where you bring the soles of the feet together and the knees fall out to the sides. So we're going to begin with the breath. So you're going to inhale through the nose, and we're going to exhale through the nose. So I'd like you to feel the breath traveling through the deep abdominals, into the chest line, into the collarbone, throat, lungs, and reverse lungs, throat, collarbone, chest, deep abdominals. So find that pattern on the front line. So we're not forcing the breath into the lower belly, just allow it to inflate naturally. And as you feel the breath travel, allow the rib cage to expand outwards. And just notice on your outward breath, the rib cage closure, like that concertina effect. As you inhale, feel the ribs floating to the side, and the breath is then taken naturally towards the lower back. As you exhale, see if you can soften through your jawline, soften through the sternum, melt down through that middle. Breath is a powerful tool in our mindset, not only in terms of calming the nervous system, but in finding our focus, in finding that positivity and that harmony with body, mind, and breath. When you unite all three, the system works as one, together, free in the body, free in the mind, and allowing you to be at one with yourself. I want you to take a focus on the back line with the breath. So as you inhale, feel your breath almost starting from the root of the body, so below the waistband, and feel it travel into the small of your back, through the back of the rib cage, between the blades, into the neck, into the base of the head. And as you send the breath away, allow the head to relax fully into the mat. Allow the shoulders to dissolve. Allow the ribs to be free. And in turn, the mind, the body, reflect that. As you send the breath at the back of that spine, feel the space in between the joints increase as you send oxygen and nutrients to the area. And notice as the spine elongates, so does the openness through the heart center on the front line, as does the capacity to breathe more deeply, and it will allow us to function more effectively. then take your mind so you travel the breath almost in a loop. So you're going to go from below the navel on the front line into the chest, into the collarbone, throat, lungs. Now send the breath down the back line of your body. So the lungs are situated at the back, between the shoulder blades, to the ribs, small of back, into the base. And you might be on four breaths in, four breaths out. You may be on six, seven, wherever you go. It's where the body can manage without stalling the breath. And then reverse it. Allow the breath to start from the root of the body. So you go below the waistband, through the small of the back, into the shoulders, into the lungs, and then it comes back through the front line on your exhalation this time. Just as the body is designed to move forward and back, side to side, right to left, you want to be able to change the breath pattern to suit what you're doing and what you're aiming to achieve. Now continue with the breath that suits your body. And I just want you to allow the toes to completely relax. Allow the fingertips to relax. Allow the ankles to let go of any tension. Allow the wrists to let go of any tension. As you allow the legs to be long, let the arms be longer. You can always turn the palms to the sky. That'll open now your chest line. And as you open your chest line, think about opening through your hip line so the hips and knees may turn out. Release through the head to open through the neck, the jaw. Letting the eyebrows part to release any tension across the forehead. And take time to notice how this state feels, mentally, physically, emotionally. And begin to circle your wrists, circle your ankles. You can change direction. And then we're going to bring our knees towards the chest. Have a little hug. And if you feel you need a full body stretch after your hug, into a stretch, then do so. And you might want to roll from side to side and then yawn open through the hip line as you lengthen the fingertips over the head, the toes away from the body. And then bring your arms down to the side, curl into a little ball. And you can either roll up into a seated position, or then you can turn to the side